Hi, welcome to Watch It Played. My name is Rodney Smith, and in this video, we're going to learn the 3-7 player game expansion Between Two Cities Capitals, which also includes variant rules for 1 and 2 players. This was designed by Ben Rossett and Matthew O'Malley and published by Stonemaier Games. If you've never played the core game, Between Two Cities, you'll need that in order to use this expansion. We have a full rules video for Between Two Cities, which you'll find linked in the description of this video. But for now, let's go to the table and learn how to play this expansion, Capitals. Included in the game are these 21 civic building tiles. When setting up, mix these in with the base game tiles. The expansion also comes with these 7 landscape mats. Randomly deal one between each pairing of players. I'll be setting up a 3-player game, so they would get placed like this. Each mat has an arrow printed on it, and ensure that all of them are pointed towards the center of the playing area. These are the 3 district scoring tiles, which you'll place in the center of the table. Then shuffle these 7 district cards and randomly deal 2 face up above each scoring tile. You'll have 1 left over to discard, unless one of your pairings within a district puts the house and the factory directly together, in which case you'll discard the 1 on the right and replace it with that 7th undealt district. And that's the setup. Playing Between Two Cities with the Capitals expansion uses all of the rules of the original game, but adds in some new ones as well. During the 1st and 3rd rounds, instead of drawing 7 tiles, you'll now draw 9. And not only does that mean that each player will get an extra turn during those rounds, but the cities are now going to be larger, and you need to incorporate within them these landscape mats. So let's take a look at how these work. Instead of each city being made up of 4x4 squares, they'll now be 5x5. But fully within that, you'll need to fit the 3x3 landscape mat. For example, in this partially completed city, I couldn't put a tile here, as now the width of this city is made up of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 squares. So instead, I might place it here. Each mat will have 5 squares that are filled in with art and cannot be used. However, there will always be 4 empty spaces where you will place city tiles. In fact, the first tile placed in any city must be on an open space of the mat. After that, as usual, future tiles are played adjacent to ones already placed. So the next tile could go here or here. On many mats, you'll find this graphical element, which represents a bridge. Here, it's going across this open canyon, while here it's going through this mountain. In either case, it will be connecting 2 tiles, treating them as adjacent. So we could have also put this next tile into the square here. But remember, this adjacency counts during scoring. So in other words, this factory and house are treated as if they are side by side for scoring purposes. I should also mention that when scoring shops with this increased city size, if you have 4 in a row, it's 16 points as before, while 5 in a row scores you 18 points. We also have these new civic buildings, and they score in a unique way, so let's learn about those next. At the end of the game, these will score individually based on the symbols shown in the upper left-hand corner. Each will have 2 types of building tiles that are positive, which they prefer to be adjacent to, and 1 that's negative, which should be avoided. This elementary school, for example, wants to be adjacent to houses or parks, but not taverns. At the end of a game, if any civic tile is not adjacent to any of the positive or negative tiles listed on it, then it scores 1 point. Using the elementary school as our example here, it doesn't have any parks, houses, or taverns adjacent to it, so it would be worth 1 point. But now let me switch things around. Here, it's now actually surrounded by 3 of the things it likes, houses. However, as long as there's at least 1 negative building tile adjacent to it, then it will also only score 1 point. It doesn't matter what else is adjacent. For now, though, let's remove this negative building tile and replace it with something neutral. As long as a civic building is adjacent to at least 1 of its positive types of buildings, it will score 3 points. So in this example, because it's adjacent to at least 1 building type it likes, a house, it will be worth 3 points. The extra houses here don't increase its score. Now, if a civic building is adjacent to both types of positive tiles that it likes, again, no matter how many times, it's worth 6 points. These scoring rules are indicated on the bottom of each civic tile, so you don't have to memorize them, you can just follow the symbols shown here. One last thing I should mention about civic tiles is that they do not count as an additional tile type when you're scoring your houses. You might remember, these benefit from being in cities with a variety of other tile types. So although this is obviously not a completed city that we're looking at right here, if we pretended it was, we would say this house is in a city with four different types, not five. The final new rule we need to discuss are districts, which are represented by these tiles and the random pairings of two tile types above each one. A district is a region of connected tiles that share any combination of the paired type. For example, District 1 shows factories and taverns. In this completed city, we see a district of them that run through these tiles. But just to be clear, let me highlight them for you now. And remember, connections are not counted diagonally. So these two taverns are not connected to this bigger district. However, keep in mind you don't have to have both types represented within a district. So these two taverns are their own district even though there's not a factory connected to them. So in this case, we actually have two District 1s. The larger one we pointed out here, and the smaller one. That said, each city only counts its largest district of each type. So for District 1, this city would say its largest grouping are these six tiles. For District 2, we're looking for any combinations of parks and offices. In this city, we actually have three different District 2s. A loan office here, one here, and then this, which is made up of four connected tiles. So this city would count four tiles as its largest District 2. For District 3, it's looking for shops and civic buildings, so for this city, it would say its largest grouping are these two shops. At the end of the game, after individual tiles are scored, you'll score each of the districts. And the city with the largest district of a given pairing will gain the value on the left, and the second largest gains the value on the right. Though a single city cannot score both first and second place for the same district. And if that would happen, look for the next highest within another city and score it for that district. If there's a tie for the largest of a particular district amongst several cities, combine the score values found on that tile and then divide them among the tied cities, rounding down, awarding no scores for second place. So if two cities were scored for the largest district in District 1, you combine these for a total of 12 and then divide, giving 6 points to each. If there's a tie for just second place in a district, those cities split the secondary value evenly, rounding down. As an aside, I should mention that the game does come with new scoring references with these new rules indicated on them, as well as new city tokens. These can be used with or in place of the other tokens you already have, just to add some visual variety. There are also rules included for one and two player games, but I'll leave those for you to discover on your own. And that's everything you need to know to play Between Two Cities Capitals with your base set of the game. If you have any questions at all about anything you saw here, don't hesitate to put them in the comments below and I'll gladly answer them as soon as I get a chance. But until the next episode, thanks for watching.